MHRD has made it mandatory for all the PhD scholars to get the plagiarism clearance for their doctoral work. The permissible upper limit for it is 25%. While doing PhD itself is a laborious, time-consuming task, UGC's directive came as another big hurdle to be cleared. Now, to give an insight on it, we are joined by Dr. A.S. Chakravarti, sir, who is the assistant professor and also the coordinator for anti-plagiarism software that has been introduced in the Usmania University. Hello, sir. So, what exactly is plagiarism?
Plagiarism is nothing but copying of information from others, theft, kidnapping of others' information. Everything comes under this, automatically detects and it rejects that, whatever the student copies.
Okay. So, can you, what are the problems that are occurred because of plagiarism? What is the trend in that?
Okay. In Usmania, we have started almost 18 months back. Mm-hmm. Since then, I've checked almost 1400 theses. Out of that, average copied information is 35 to 40% in that. Okay. And majority of the people copying for the sake of introduction and reference, review of literature.
Okay.
Okay. This is the major problem in Usmania. And for that reason, we are checking 2 to 3 times each, again and again. Mm. And finally, they are submitting almost 511 theses submitted in last year.
Okay.
In the year of 18. 500 theses submitted, 511. Mm-hmm. And still this year people are doing research in the right way. And so much of change in the campus. In Usmania, okay, after introduction of this plagiarism, we have introduced in 2018 July. Mm-hmm. We have taken Turnitin anti-plagiarism software, 250 users in the first year. And almost all the faculty members got access to Turnitin. And they can also check their documents. Even finally, I'm the coordinator, I'll check and certify. Based on that, they will submit in the examination branch. Mm. And this year, we have extended that up to 400 user access. Okay. And we are providing access to each and every teacher. Mm. As well as I'm personally conducting awareness programs in each and every department, various departments in campus, right, and other colleges in Usmania. There is a lot of change in campus. To be frank, first people are facing some problems for the presentation of their thesis. Mm-hmm. Later, because of the English word they express, that creating so many problems. And fortunately, our students are intelligent, but they are unable to present in a proper way. That is the reason the percentage is more when compared to the universities. And due to that presentation, while presenting their thesis, mm-hmm, they are copying from various sources. Right. And we have 3 ways in copying that. Some people, they intentionally they do that, and unintentionally they do, and they will also do self-plagiarism. These are the 2-3 types actually, right, according to the plagiarism.org. These are the identified ways to plagiarize. The thing is, the third, in Usmania, according to my experience, the third part is, in majority of the cases I've seen. Mm-hmm. Like what they are doing, they are publishing so many papers from their thesis. And the same information they are presenting in their thesis, and it creates so many problems. According to Usmania policy, we are excluding the published articles from the thesis while checking, final checking. So that is very better for the students, and it is reducing so much of percentage. Of course, we are going in the right way.
So can you give us a few guidelines to avoid plagiarism?
Yes. Research is nothing but we have to continue the existing one. Mm-hmm. Definitely we have to copy some extent. We have to continue where the research is stopped. Okay, at that moment we have to copy from various sources. The thing is, we have to represent the information from other sources. Here in Usmania, my observation is, people are copying from various sources and presenting as it is. Without citation.
Right.
This is very big problem, because before going to submit the PhD, the research scholar should know what is plagiarism first. What are the styles of plagiarism and presentation styles, even bibliographic styles like APA, MLH, because each and every standard format avoids plagiarism. Because of that, what people are doing here in this Usmania, they are copying from various sources and presenting as its own, and it starts creating problems in that way.
So there are many students out there who actually are, you know, choose plagiarism a lot. Are there any punishments who?
Yes, so many punishments are there. Mm-hmm. Because of, academic problems will be there. If majority of the students copy in a particular department, people, what they will think, in that particular department, each and every research output will be copied. Okay, and if it is anything in the university, entire university, if so many people will copy in a university, people will, what they will think, in Usmania, because or otherwise any university, is majority of the students copy, like that, it creates problems. But in Usmania, we are almost controlling our research. And the financial problems will be there, because before this plagiarism, we have to concentrate on copyright first, mm-hmm. and intellectual property right, because copyright protects the right of the author. Here, if you copy anything, automatically we have to face so many problems like monetary problems, legal problems, something like. And we have to protect intellectual property rights. In that way, we can avoid some extent.
So, what kind of punishments that are, you know, usually of course, students face?
The punishment stage, we are not at reached at up to that mark. But mm-hmm. according to the universal punishment standards, like getting lower grade, and rejecting PhDs, and taking back of scholarships and all, like this punishments will be there, and cancellation of PhD, like that. If it is causes more than 60%, automatically there is a rule according to Gazette of India that was introduced in 2018. If any student causes 60% of copied information, then that will be rejected, and that student come again after 1 year. This is the rule Government of India implemented.
Okay, so what are the different, you were talking about how there is a software that has been introduced in Usmania University as well. So what are the different kind of softwares that are, you know, used to identify the plagiarism yes. that happens?
So many software on internet, free software, commercial software, so many things are there. Like what we purchased is Turnitin. The scope of Turnitin is more, almost 90% of literature available on internet, it covers maybe billions of papers, hundreds of lakhs of journals, it covers even commercial databases, it enters and checks. But whereas so many other software like duplicate checker, exchequer, Viper, so many softwares are there where you can check online, it creates sometimes it creates problems to research scholars. Why? Because if you check any document online, that will be indexed on their server. If I check again in my server, again it will show more than 100%, like 100% copied. Why? Because that was indexed into that server, and it creates so many problems to remove that from the server, because commercial softwares, they'll accept our request. But whereas open source or free software, they will not listen our words. If it is indexed, we cannot remove. But whereas in Turnitin, we have so many options in that we can put one option before uploading our thesis, that no repository or do not index. That we will do in that. If you check the same document several times, it will not be indexed.
Okay, so how authentic are those software? Because you mentioned about the technical errors yes. also.
Free software checks only the information about where it is available free, like web resources. It will not enter into commercial databases or commercial journals. Only some extent it will check, and it will give the percentage like 4 or 5%. Like if you check the same document in Turnitin, maybe it crosses more than 40 or 50%, because the scope of this Turnitin is more, and it enters into so many databases.
Okay, so what are the cautions to be taken by the researchers to, you know, avoid plagiarism?
Yes. Nothing, plan ahead. Before going to start writing your report, you have to know about what is plagiarism, and how to avoid that. And citation is the important thing in that. Each and every copied information that we have to cite. We have to present the source of that information. And we have to give credit of the owner of that information. Otherwise, what people will think that, that is your own creation. Mm-hmm. And this software checks and it shows that similarity is there. If you present the source of that information, automatically it excludes. That is the thing, and all definitions, statements that we can avoid, because that automatically excludes that. Facts, figures, everything, we have to present the citation for that. Even what people will think that images, if I copy images or tables from the internet, nothing will happen. People will think of that. But the thing is, if this plagiarism is, checks each and every figure, table, everything. Okay? This this software Turnitin is not content based. This is concept based. Okay? If you copy the content from various sources, some people, what they will record, according to my observation in Usmania, what they will do, they will change the words. After copying that, they will change the words by using synonyms. But Turnitin still checks, because the content, concept of that paragraph, the sequence of the words which are not changed, it automatically identifies. It still it checks and it provides the copied information.
Okay, so coming to the software that you mentioned that has been introduced in the university, how exactly does the software work?
Yes, of course, so many conditions in that. Before going to upload our document into that, some limitations are there in that, like we have to give below 250 pages document. We cannot split the document, and the size of the document should be below 40 MB size. And it will check each and every character if you modify or if you adopt any malpractice in that. Okay, and it checks each and every place where information is available on internet, either commercial or open source. Okay, finally it provides the report which contains similarity.
Okay, so after introducing that software, what is the percentage, how much did it reduce in our university?
Yes, actually this is very important question. According to the Gazette of Government of India, which was released in July 2018, the condition is only 10% is acceptable.
Okay.
Where we have to check only limited chapters in that. If we are adapting 10%, then we have to check only limited chapters like objectives, synopsis, observations, conclusion, findings, abstract, something like that. But what we are doing in Usmania, we are fixed that percentage up to 25. 25% is the maximum limit, and we are checking each and every chapter. There is no exclusion in that. Even we will check introduction, because majority of the cases in Usmania, students are copying for the sake of introduction and review of literature. But the thing is, students can present review of literature by rewriting in their own sentence, but people are not doing in Usmania. In that way, people can avoid duplication, and our limit is 25. If that exceeds, we will send it back for correction, for rewriting.
Okay. So, how are the students taking this change in the university?
Yeah. Of course, a lot of change has happened in Usmania. When we introduced, we faced so many problems. Pressures, still I have explained each and every student and how to rewrite that. I am acting as a mentor, even I am acting as a supervisor for various subject scholars, and I am guiding them. And of course, people are coming in a good way finally, and they are submitting. Nobody has faced any problem because of my guidance or something like. Even I'm giving lectures in various places, each and every department, almost all the departments are covered in Usmania, and majority of the scholars or faculty members attended for that, and some awareness is there in students about plagiarism, and still we have to control so much of things in Usmania.
Okay, so one last question I have, While you were mentioning about how the software works and all, one question popped up was, there are situations where there is one last statement which is usually common in most of the researchers, like for example, A is equal to B, or hence A is similar to B. If you see that, many write in the similar way. So will that be considered as plagiarism? Will that come under that?
Yes. According to the Gazette of Government of India, up to 14 characters, it will not check.
Okay.
This software checks after 14 words. Like from 15th word onwards, it will check. A is equal to A square is equal to B square comes under 4 or 5 characters. It will not check that. Mm-hmm. It will start checking from 15th word onwards. Okay. So that it will be avoided. We are also applying the same filtration in Usmania, and we are applying each and every scholar that 14 words filtration in Usmania.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, sir. So, thank you so much for giving us a detailed insight about plagiarism, sir. So, this was Dr. A.S. Chakravarti, sir, who gave us a detailed description about what plagiarism is, how the anti-plagiarism software has been launched in our university, and how much it has brought the change in the students as well.